So business planning and entrepreneurship management. Second module, we are discussing about classification and types of entrepreneurs. Here you can see the classification. We started with classifying the entrepreneurs into various categories according to growth, stages of development, like that. Then this also we have seen in the earlier lecture. Classification of entrepreneurs by Clarence Danoff. Then who is an intrapreneur? The characteristics and qualities of an intrapreneur. Classification of intrapreneurs. Advantages and disadvantages of intrapreneurship. Now we are going to discuss about women entrepreneurs. Who is a women entrepreneur? What is women entrepreneur? Now women entrepreneurship is again recognized or considered as a very important source of economic growth in our country, because they create jobs for themselves, and not only that, they also create opportunities for others for getting employment. But still the thing is that in our country and all in many other countries, not only in our country, they still represent a minority of all entrepreneurs. Like we cannot count them into like so many women entrepreneurs are not there still in the market. They face a lot of issues also when they are starting the business, like gender-based biases they face, then discriminations, then matrimonial inheritance laws, like so many problems also they face when they are entering into this field. Now here, just remember these two definitions over here. According to Government of India, what is a woman, or who is a woman entrepreneur, or what is this women enterprises? It is an enterprise owned and controlled by a woman having a minimum financial interest of 51% of the capital and giving at least 51% of the employment generated by the enterprise to women. This is the definition given by Government of India. And another one simple definition is over here. Women who innovate, imitate, or adopt a business activity are called women entrepreneur, according to Joseph Schumpeter. So women entrepreneur, there is, it is just a gender-based classification of entrepreneurship. Gender-based classification of entrepreneurship, but at the same time, they belong to the minority group where we cannot find a lot number of women entrepreneurs in the world. At the same time, there are several successful women entrepreneurs who have created a mark for the upcoming generations as well. So remember these two definitions. In the first one, it is given by Government of India, where 51% of the financial capital, if it is held by women and they are giving employment opportunities also for 51% of the women. So this is about the definition part. Now, what are the different features of women entrepreneurs? There are some type of peculiar features which we cannot find among, or we cannot see amongst the male members, we can say. Like here you can see persistence. First one is persistence. What is this persistence? Around eight points we will see over here. First one is persistence. Persistence means continuity. Continuity and the determination to get something done. Women entrepreneurs have a strong intention to fulfill their dreams. And many studies show that women entrepreneurs work very hard and they continuously put their efforts in all the different or all the difficult situations. Aur unka kaise hote hai, bhale kuch bhi ho jaye, they are ready to take the risk whichever is coming in front of them. And they are ready to put the hard work for getting the success, and they continue this effort. The effort are consistent. That is the meaning of being persistent. Always the same, ready to face the challenges. Second one, sense of responsibility. Already we know that women will be having dual responsibility. Dual responsibility means they, of course, they will have to be managing their home. And at the same time, when they start a business, this also becomes a responsibility for them. But they have a deep sense of responsibility. They are highly responsible for the venture they are beginning into. Or whether be it a small one or a large one, they are highly sensible or highly they have this attitude of responsibility towards their business. Flexibility. Due to this inherent feminine nature, women have this ability to change according to the demands in the business. like they can easily understand the pulse of the customers, and according to the demands of the customers, they can change. Imagination. Most of the women entrepreneurs have a good sense of imagination, creativity, and innovation. They also have a fantasy type of character where they keep on thinking about new ideas. Then organizing capacity. Women are good managers. They really know how to manage people and how to get the work done out of the people. And they can also find the right person for the right job. Then high level of optimism. All of you know the meaning of optimism. Optimism means having a positive attitude. And women have a high confidence in their ability, and generally they succeed in their ventures. Might be smaller in number, but generally most of the women who are entering into this field, they come out successful because they have a positive attitude towards what they are doing, and that is high level of optimism. They are ready to face whatever is coming in their way. Then of course, hard work, attribute to hard work. Definitely the imaginative ideas, the creative ideas and all which they are having in their mind, that should be converted into action. For that, it is very much important to work hard. And hard work is definitely needed to build up an enterprise and also to keep it running. So for this purpose, we can say that definitely all the women entrepreneurs are hardworking. Then value of self-fulfillment. Women entrepreneurs are not only motivated by money. Of course, economic conditions also make many women entrepreneurs to enter into business. But apart from that, we can say that self-fulfillment. Aur khud ke liye kuch to chahiye, kuch to banke dikhana hai society ke samne. Such kind of attitude, such kind of belief actually drives the women to enter into this field. So one basic motivating force will be self-fulfillment, because they have a creative urge to do something and show that to the society. So we can say that, of course, money is important. Of course, profit is important. Rather than that, they have this motivation to do something in front of others. Do something successfully in front of others. So these are the very common features of women entrepreneurs. They have this persistence quality. Persistence means always being consistent and putting hard work, or having a strong intention to fulfill their dreams. They have the sense of responsibility towards their venture, towards whatever they are starting. They have they are attracted to this, and they have a huge attachment to this enterprise. Flexible, they can be modified as per the requirements in the market. They are highly imaginative, creative, and innovative. They have excellent organizing capacity, because they can easily understand whom should be selected to work under them and how to take out the best from these people. Then of course, high level of optimism or positive attitude. Then hard work, they put lot of efforts for their firm. Whatever, be it a small firm or a large firm, they try to build and sustain the enterprise in the market. Then value of self-fulfillment, which is a major motivating force behind this. Now moving ahead, you can see some common features of women entrepreneurs in India. This is just a small topic to understand the condition in India. Like basically being a developing country and also being driven by various traditions, customs, various different types of religion and all, sometimes the growth of women entrepreneurs in India are not as much as when we compare to that of many developed countries outside. Now there are certain features over here which makes them distinct from other group of entrepreneurs. Some of them are, majority of these people are married, and unmarried women normally face difficulties in getting the financial support. Many women entrepreneurs belong to the low income group. Most of the women entrepreneurs, they lack vocational training. What is this vocational training? Vocational training are this training which are provided in technical areas, like to, for example, some particular skills they can develop after attending such vocational training. It could be anything up to their interest. Now, many women become entrepreneurs out of economic necessity. Gender discrimination is very much common in our country. Women with small families are more likely to become entrepreneurs in our country, and they prefer diversification to specialization. Diversification means instead of focusing only on one product, they normally prefer, or they normally like to go for different types of products. And they are security oriented rather than growth oriented. For women, they want a secure income. They are not much bothered about high profits or not. And same way, they prefer stabilization of income, and they are normally ready to take minimum risk rather than bringing maximum profit into the company. These are the common features of women entrepreneurs in our country. It may vary from individual to individual. Some notable differences which is being observed, that is mentioned over here. But of course, we can say that nowadays things are changing. Nowadays, government is coming forward with so many special schemes that we will see here in this topic itself. We will see so that women entrepreneurs are equally getting opportunities to enter into the business field. These are just common features which are found in India. Now, what is this importance of women entrepreneurs? If we see, women entrepreneurs are actually creating a very significant contribution or very significant impact in almost every area in most of the developed countries. But initially, of course, women has this problem to enter into business. They face several challenges. But once they start, women can actually make us, particularly compared to men, they can run a business much more easily. The thing is, they will have to manage dual responsibilities. Now, when we take that of many foreign countries, we can see that so many areas are there where women's participation is quite notable. In India, when it comes to India, we still have to utilize and mobilize resources. Today, still things are changing. Even now, like we can say, to an extent, things are changing. Women is being accepted as an indicator of social development. But still, whether they are getting due recognition to all their contributions, still it is a doubt. Now, how did these women entrepreneurs develop? Like we can say that when we talk about our country, last few years, it has seen a huge change in the entrepreneurship culture itself in our country. Many women started entering into the business. People started taking courage to enter into business, and they even started taking care of family business and all. Like many people started thinking about self-employment. They accepted the share of work and responsibilities at home. They wanted to show something to the society. Another important thing was many women started getting educated, especially technological and professional education. The people, especially women who are entering into technical and professional education, started increasing. Because of this one reason, they started making personal choices and they started entering into this field, taking the courage. Sometimes society was not at all ready to accept them, but still they started in a smaller way. And by the time of 1990s and all, women started becoming more and more capable, more and more confident, and they were clear, or they were having more idea about their goals and achievements. And many of these women are self-employed. They engaged in the unorganized sector. Unorganized sector are those sector like which is coming under agriculture, industries and all, and home-based industries. So here in India, we can say that education, literacy, growth, and like both in professional and technological, that has actually contributed to the growth of women development. Like when it came to 21st century and all, when IT industry started booming in our country, women again emerged as an expertise in all these areas. We can see so many companies, banking sector, communication sector and all, many companies are being headed and guided by women as the top people. They have entered into many business, but still they have a long way to go ahead. The country cannot be told to be fully developed without recognizing the contribution of women also in the country. Still, we can say that even though things are being changed, they have a long way to go ahead. Now, let us see certain special schemes for women entrepreneurs. Now, with a view to make these women entrepreneurs come forward and to make them financially stable, government and many financial institutions are providing them various schemes. So these are the common schemes which are available to them. First one is seed capital. Seed capital means in order to start their own business, government provides some fund, provides some initial fund to unemployed youngsters and women to women people. It could be around 10% to 15% of the total cost of the project. And even if they are coming from a backward class, the percentage will again increase. Now, the women is normally treated unemployed even if their husband is working or doing any kind of business. And what the criteria here is that they should be at least 7th standard pass and they should not be above 50 years of age. And the contribution, the seed capital which is given is around 5 lakhs. And there is, in every district, there will be district industry center known as DIC. So when these people are approaching them, they will be getting more details over there. It is just the initial capital. That is why it is known as a seed capital. A seed capital is the initial help which is being provided by the government. Same way, National Equity Fund, it is implemented by National Bank or even known as State Finance Corporation. Here, there is no age limitation or any condition of education over here. Loan is provided for both product-oriented or service-oriented activity. The thing is that 10% should be contributed by the individual. Remaining, they will help in funding. Same way, finance corporation, this is again schemes introduced by the finance section for entrepreneurs, even especially to women entrepreneurs. Then there is PM's Employment Guarantee Scheme, that is Prime Minister's Employment Guarantee Scheme. Here, this is given by the central government. Age limit is 35 years and minimum education is 10 standard. 95% of loan is given by the bank. And it is not the candidate, I mean the person who wants to take this benefit, they are not expected to contribute anything. Instead, the subsidy will be given. Then there is Women Industries Fund Scheme. Here also they are getting around 15% of this seed capital. Single window scheme. What is a single window scheme? Like, this is done in order to facilitate women entrepreneurs to get every activity in one place. Like getting loan, working capital, and from one and the same institution, they can approach one place. And this is but applicable for both male and female. And they will be getting around up to 20 lakhs. And they also have to contribute here, but they can get everything at one place itself. Then there is joint loan scheme. Here also there is no age restriction or any educational qualification restriction. Around 50,000 will be paid and it should be repaid by within 8 years. Then District Industry Center, DIC, this is something which I told now. It is about having a support system in every district in the country. And the main objective is here is to provide financial help to start industries in the rural areas where the population is less than 1 lakh. Here, again, they provide so much of help, and this is also sponsored by the government. Then there is training and extension services. Training and extension services doesn't involve like any major financial aspect here. Instead, they will be given training. Women will be given training through approved agencies like Entrepreneurship Development Institute of India, then several NGOs, State Social Welfare Board, like that. After that, during this period, their expenses will be borne by the sponsors. After this, they will be getting the evaluation report, where after that they can enter into any business field. Then there is scheme for refinance assistance. Refinance assistance means again it will be for women entrepreneurs. Here again, they will be having to spend around 12.5%, and there are different varying interest over here. The main thing is again for supporting women through providing them financial help. In many of these cases, the thing is that women entrepreneurs are not at all aware that such schemes are there in our country. The main agent or the main people who will be responsible to convey this would be the district industry center. Through them, they can get to know about various such schemes. So these, why these schemes are introduced? These schemes are introduced in order to increase the participation of women in the market, so that they also contribute to the economic development of the country. Now, the recent trends which we can see about women development of women entrepreneurs, we have to actually treat them as specific target groups. Like here, the government has also put in a lot of efforts to make them come to the forefront. Like regarding, it's actually contributing to the society as well. When a woman is getting educated, it helps to build their family. And when they are working, it also again contributes, it will actually contribute to the standard of living of the family. It will bring the extra income into the family. Overall, the entire family will get benefited. So for these purpose, every time women is given special importance by the government, they are treated as specific target group in almost all the developmental programs. Women's participation in decision making is encouraged and it is to be increased. Marketing assistance would be given. Normally, this could be one area where women entrepreneurs lack behind. They have to market their products. So for that, marketing assistance will be provided. Diverse vocational training would be provided. Then encouraging appropriate technologies, using of different type of equipments, etc., to increase the efficiency of women entrepreneurs, because many equipments would be quite sophisticated. Now, problems faced by women entrepreneurs. Again, in India, when it comes to India, we know that family responsibilities or dual responsibilities actually prevent a woman for entering into business. Forget about entering into business. Even when they want to work in a normal firm or a normal profession, if they have to take up, they have to think a lot. So in India, the involvement of women actually in the family itself leaves little time and energy for business. And especially if the woman is married, they need to face several problems in the family and a role conflict can happen. Because of this, the entry of women into business becomes quite difficult. Same way, social attitude. Still, even now, we can say that despite the constitution is talking about equality to women, still there is some kind of discrimination existing against the women. Especially if it is a tradition-bound society in rural areas and all, the resistance is coming not only from the male members, but even from the elderly people in the society, that women cannot work and they are restricted into their home. They are supposed to be sitting at their home. Then low mobility. Women on their own find it difficult to get accommodation in towns, and it becomes one of the major difficulty because they cannot frequently move, leaving their family behind, and traveling from one place to another and all can be quite difficult for them. High cost of production, mobilization of resources, bringing the resources together and entering into production activity bearing the high cost of production can be quite difficult for women. Lack of education. In India, we know that if it is a very poor family, they give preference for male education only, even now. Females again lag behind when it comes to education, and even there women lag behind in technological knowledge, marketing skills, etc. This can become a problem for women. Low need for achievement. Need for achievement in the sense they need to be independent, they need to have autonomy over the control over the business and all. So this many times will not be possible. Male members may try to become the center of the business, and they may try to develop an autonomy type of situation in the business. Because of this, women tend to go behind. Shortage of finance. they always suffer from inadequate financial resources because they need to actually get the finance from someone else many times. Even for their day-to-day operations also, they will have to arrange the finance. Inefficient arrangement for marketing and data, especially women who are not much having much knowledge about marketing or outside conditions, they will have to depend on others, and especially middlemen can be called over here, and there are chances that these middlemen also exploit the women's illiteracy over here. Then shortage of raw materials, they find it difficult to procure the raw materials and necessary inputs required. And many people who are entering into this and entrepreneurship actually come back, or they actually withdraw from this because they find it difficult to arrange all the resources. Stiff competition, because it is all imperfect market setup or organizational setup. As we know, entrepreneurs always they suffer competition from various organized industries and even many other companies. So the same thing is applicable for women entrepreneurs as well. Now, how, one more last topic here is about how to develop strategies for developing. It's very easy to understand. Educate them, providing education and awareness, especially elderly people in the society also, so that women can make a difference in the society. Better time management. It is not that the women cannot manage this dual responsibility. The family members also should be involved over here. Setting up home-based business. We can see that so many women have come forward, like cake making, tailoring units, or jewelry business, and all are home-based business which can be undertaken by home. Thereby, they can manage both household responsibilities as well. Efficient use of IT, especially now using internet, social media marketing, setting up a website and all. This type of knowledge also should be passed on to the women. Organizing workshop and seminar so that they will be able to know about various organizations which are providing financial support for the women. Group entrepreneurship is very, very successful, especially among the weaker section of the society. It will actually empower the women and provide them necessary confidence for entrepreneurship. In this case, many NGOs, many women's cooperative units and all come forward. You might have heard about this Lijjat Pappad. These are all started in a smaller way and they have succeeded. That is actually the group of women together. Then procedures should be simplified. Procedures for getting financial assistance by bank, government institutions and all should be simplified to make it easier for the women. Dispense collateral security. Collateral security means providing some kind of security when you take a loan from a bank or any, maybe your house or maybe some plot of land or jewelry or anything like that. Now, when many times women are actually dependent on men, especially in married family and all, they hardly will be having any property or any assets in their name. And so avoid collateral security. Instead, provide them some kind of subsidies in the initial stage itself. Financial can be, or it is operated by various public sector banks and many institutions for providing easy information to women on how it could be, how finance can be, or how they will get this capital support and what are the terms and conditions related to that. Training facility should be, so the courses should be designed in such a way that even women can learn these courses. Like there are so many courses, mobile training centers and all, they can actually help women in undertaking training so that they can acquire more and more new skills. And with the assistance of the family members and with the support and with the financial support provided by the government, with the will and determination to go ahead, definitely women entrepreneurs can contribute to the society.